Well, I suppose I'd be expected to say City of Death, because everybody loves that above all Doctor Who programmes of all time, apparently. And I'd agree with it because I love Douglas Adams and he wrote it, so I'd say City of Death. Yeah. I don't do that many. I do a few. I always enjoy them because we seem to attract a very, very nice fan base. You know, they're incredibly friendly, and often, particularly the ones in England, you meet the same people over and over again. It's a sort of large family. Well, it's a second career. I've had four exhibitions on my own now of things that I do with sewing machines. The knitting books are way back. That was about 1980-something. I've kind of grown out of that. But I'm always doing something. I'm either illustrating something or doing my thread drawings and stuff like that. I didn't watch Doctor Who when I was in it. I didn't watch it beforehand, and I probably won't pick it up now, just because I don't really watch television much. I kind of binge on videos when they come out sometimes, but I don't really watch television. I've no idea. I'm sure she's really good, and it would be very interesting to know how people feel that she's doing. For 27 years now, it's a residential and dementia and care home for old actors, members of the theatrical profession. It's a wonderful place. I'm trying to persuade people it's a model of how one can do things, because it's, if you create that sort of environment within a profession, you create a society, really. You have people who share interests, and it's not just the residents, it's their families as well. So I love it with all my heart. It's hard work. It's been very tough over the years. It's a very difficult sector. We struggle, everybody does. But one meets the most wonderful people, and I consider myself incredibly lucky to have been part of this community for so long.
I draw with a sewing machine. It's sort of, it's kind of scribbled really, but I do it with a sewing machine rather than with a pencil, and I just do it freehand, and it's done on silk and Japanese cotton and bits of felt and things, and it takes hours and hours and hours and hours, and I put my love and my heart into it. And the signature is my very own, drawn with my very own sewing machine, and I can't say any more than that, but I tell you, it's worth every penny.
It's an antique.
This is an antique. Found Knits was would you like to explain what it is, Arlo?
I think it's probably two books on knitting, and the real bonus in this, I should have got them to sign it, is there are pictures of Louise Jameson in here. and Joanna David. An actress called Gwen Watford.
Me.
Yeah.
I think most people in this room have probably seen this book before. It's very of its time.
It's definitely of its time.
So should we start with, we'll start with a £5 bid for this book. Thank you very much. That was a very easy offer.
Yeah. Louise Jameson looking unbelievable.
Have we got to £10 for this book? Oh, wow. Thank you. There's the £10. Does anyone want to take it to 20? Thank you very much. Do we have 30 pounds?
Look at this.
We're at 20, but I'd like to take it to 30. £30, thank you very much. Well, therefore, £40. Has anybody got £40? £40, anybody? Are we saying at 30? Does that feel like a reasonable price to you guys? I said, yeah, well, big thumbs up there. £30, thank you very much, sir. Thank you. So the next item is...
really have a favourite Doctor Who quote, because I can never remember any of them except the one that took me so long to learn that I now can't unremember it, the way it happens when you struggle. And it was a line in, I think, Warrior's Gate, but I can't remember exactly, and possibly not actually. Somebody anyway asked me how the TARDIS worked, and I had to say, well, we use a digitally modelled time cone isometry parallel bust into the image translator. What else?